The forest of Fangorn will burn to fuel the industry of Isengard.
Welcome back to The Lord of the Rings, The Battle for Middle-earth, and welcome back to the Evil campaign. And this time we're going to cut down the forest of Fangorn.
Fangorn is the ents' home of the Ents, an excellent source of fuel to drive the engines of industry.
Draw their strength from the Entmoot. We must destroy it.
We have much work to do.
Come
feed
to me,
our
my
forges
people.
With wood from the great forests of Fangorn. With enough fuel, we shall breed a mighty army of orcs.
Come on, you
we shall do that.
None shall oppose us.
But we shall also set some ants on fire here because they are kind of strong. There we go. And you guys light this guy here on fire. Oh dear, you're about to die, so let's maybe not do that. Let's not get you killed. That'd be nice. Someone kill this guy here, please. Yeah, the ants are pretty tough. But yeah, their fire's their great weakness if there's no who. Yeah, and even if they die, they will still kill half of my guys, but oh well. Just have to roll with it. It's going to be okay. So you just kind of hang out here and recover a little bit. And you can become group 2. And you can become group 3. And then let's walk over here and establish our base. Spoilers, there will be some elves. But that's going to be okay. We do have a lot of free pop slots, we're going to fill those up, and we also have to advance our, well, there we go, advance our economy a little bit. You can blast these guys here away if you want to, boom. You actually survived that. They will. I just want this guy to level up, so you just kill these guys here. That's a good opportunity because I don't really want to fight the Ents with Saruman unless he has the fire spell already. The fire spell isn't going to... How about you defend yourself? The fire spell isn't going to kill the Ents in the short run. It's going to do it in the long run. May as well blast these guys here, I guess. Boom. Yeah, you're not going to survive that. Bastards. So. Okay, you should probably work here. How about that? We shall do that. Not right now, but we'll get to that, no worries. Here we go. Let's establish our base. Yeah, evil mostly has cannon fodder and little healing, which is moderately annoying. But oh well. Also, let's build another sawmill here. And then let's murder you guys. Boom. And let's kill them. Alright, we want a slaughterhouse, an armory, furnace, rook pit. Keep, don't really think we need that. Let's just build my furnaces. And is it an attack? Whatever. Okay, use the devastation power to clear trees. Actually, let's just check out what we have here. Okay, Elf of Sauron, you still can't afford that. But let's see about that. Let's also get the flame arrows. We are definitely going to need those. There's just no way around it. So check out you squads here. Some of you lack some members, but I guess we can fix that once we have banners and whatnot. But we will get to that. Let's just check out the objectives here. Kill tree beds. Yeah, we're going to do this soon enough. Yeah, bloodthirst ability. Crossbowman to Heart of Uruk-hai, like a swordsman. Okay, you're going to do that. You don't really have that much experience, so that's okay. And let's see, you have pretty much no experience, that's good. And that means you can be cannibalized by these guys here. There we go. And that gives us some experience. Not too much, but it's significant. Let's combine these guys here. There we go. Was that good enough? It was. Nice. So then let's send you to the slaughterhouse. And then you give us back some resource, because I don't like combined squads. I just do not. All of you get flame arrows. Pretty expensive, but I really want the flame arrows. Also, let's get the banner upgrade once you can afford it. It's going to be pretty expensive to have this army here. Because while it is sort of small, right now we still have a lot of pop slots left. Oh, the upgrades aren't actually all that small, so the all that cheap. So all of these still cost a fair amount of money. Let's see whether we can find some more elves to kill. I mean, there's some more here, but I don't want to do those just with Saruman. It looks very Emperor Battle for Dune-ish, kind of. Anyway, you guys can cut more trees. Oh, hello. Okay, I guess we can just kill you. Release the bolts. Okay, you can. Okay, you can kill these guys here. You must go now. Boom, there we go. And then let's fire blast these guys here. And then we're going to kill the rest of those guys. There we go. You can just whack these. And you almost have reached level 3. That's really all I'm concerned about here. You can come over here and claim the spot here. I don't want to build too many lumber mills, because I do want to make sure that we have enough pop slots left for these guys here. Let's just get a slaughterhouse here. It's not that expensive anyway. And the earlier you build it, the more money we'll get from it. I'm pretty sure these do... Yeah, these do gain experience. There we go. There we go, indeed. Pretty sure you... No, I can't send Saruman in there. That would be weird. Build a tower here and a tower there, just because. And let's get the banner here. Nice, nice. Alright, you get over here. We're going to get all of you these banner upgrades here. It's also good for regeneration. And then let's see. So what's the deal with you? Really? Because you are a single group? When did that happen? Well, let's see. Whether you fully recover when we get you the banner upgrade. I'm curious about that, so let's pay attention to this guy here. And also to these guys here. Yep, it does indeed. Nice, nice. It's probably going to take a while, but these guys here should ultimately recover fully. Okay, let's get all of them banners. Yeah, so they do recover fully. And you can buy these upgrades, so you don't have to worry about... Okay, actually, we're going to do this differently. You can... Come Groove 2. The main thing that's annoying about this is that once they're damaged, they don't actually regenerate. Unless you have an ally with a well, which you generally only have in multiplayer. Do we have all the stuff here? Yes, there's no upgrades here. We have those two. Oh, hello, didn't see you there. Well, I guess you're dead now, so there's that. And yeah, so it's actually... At the end of the battle, it's actually better when everyone dies. Anyway, I think I want some more crossbow Uruk-hai here. So let's get 3 troops of these. We can't really afford more anyway. How expensive is the fire bolt upgrade? Fire arrows. There should be bolt because this is crossbows. I know that because I've played Dungeons & Dragons. Anyway, you're still cutting a lumber. Nice, nice. I suppose. You don't have to rely fully on lumber, because you can You can get furnaces and slaughterhouse and whatnot. But let's see. 850. That is very expensive. That is more than the initial squad. And we also want the banner upgrade. How expensive is that? That is also pretty expensive. All of this is pretty expensive, but oh well. Let's see. So we I think we have enough firepower to take off the elves. Would bet on that. But we're also going to get a new camp here so we can build more economic buildings once we have... Oh, hoo, hoo. So you, let's get over here. You can blast these guys here and then fireball them. Oh, that was underwhelming. So you kill these guys here and Saruman, you can... Oh, hoo, hoo, wow. Why did I do that? Why did I... Okay, whatever. So you try to kill these guys here. So you set the ants on fire. And then let's make sure that we at least kill a bunch of these guys before everyone here gets killed. Okay, so yeah, at least these guys here deal some decent damage now, so that's nice here. Catch some fire. There we go. Let's concentrate our firepower. You can improve the pits. Nice. Okay, we almost have them. It's just frustrating that none of these guys is going to heal. I know that Mordor's armies are supposed to be more cannon fodder army, as opposed to epic hero armies that just take out everyone. Let's get more of these. Let's get this one here set up, and then let's destroy these. Oh, it's not even a treasure inside. This guy here is like the Command & Conquer 3 barracks or armory guy who just hangs around there but never actually fights. There we go. They will. So I guess we can just build furnaces here. Let's industrialize this forest here a little bit. And we should probably get everyone a banner. Does everyone even have a banner? Yeah, these guys here do. These guys here do not. So we do recover, but not as I like it. Oh, boy. That's so cute. That said, you can join these guys here. Let's get those. If you can afford it, you can come over here. Can build more stuff here. I know we can build lumber mills here, but I kind of want to have... Oh, that looks like a bad idea. You're going to take this path here. There's probably just more elves there. We're going to build these for now. We can always destroy them later if we really want to.
None shall oppose us. Let us go draw now. Their strength from the Entmoot. We must destroy it.
Yep. We will destroy it. Do I just want more crossbows? I have the feeling that's kind of the way to go here. Even though the range is kinda terrible, you definitely need Firebolt. There's just no way around it. You definitely need your upgrades. You can come over here. So we still have enough... We have money for what? Let's just get one more of these troops here. Oh wait, that costs 30 points. These cost 20 points. I guess we're going to get you then. Could get another one of these troops here because these all cost one point. We'll see. We might build another one of those. But let's go with this army here for now. It's not as impressive as it looks. These aren't rangers, so keep that in mind. And we will see about that. Let's wait until that last troop is ready. Welcome, everyone. Yeah, these guys cost a ton of command points. They're kind of anemic for that, but then again, I also have a huge amount of command points readily available. This is already more than the good guys have at the end of the campaign. That said, these guys here still work, work, king. Yeah, this seems to be all right. Okay. Watchhand, we might use that. You know what? May as well use the Palantir here. So here's a bunch of elves, so we're going to go down here and murder all of those. And then we'll see whether we can... There we go, let's get some banners here. Let's see how far... Why did you just move there? I guess those guys were in your way. We'll see how far we get here. Yeah, Saruman can take a lot of firepower for... well, fire, not firepower for an old man, but then again, he's not a human, he's a, like, not an angel, I'm just gonna call him that. Magical being thingy? You know what I mean. There we go. At least we can kill these elves here quickly. Then again, if you get hit by 12 crossbow bolts at once, you're probably going to die rather quickly. Most people would. There we go. Yep. Overwhelming firepower. Please kill my guys so they actually respawn. You get over here. The elves are kind of nasty because they are actually melee fighters as well. They can switch. There we go. And ooh, there's more of them than I thought. I guess may as well blast them, these guys here. And you just kill those guys here. There's a lot more of them than I thought. But it's okay. We'll kill them all. Let's see how many of these guys we actually lost. I don't think we have to replace an entire troop, but let's wait a little bit. I'm pretty sure you don't recover during combat. I think you have to wait a little bit. Just like the hero ability, the regeneration ability needs a while to kick in. Okay. There we go, that's a bit better. Yeah, so we may as well go down here. So we should have enough pop. Yeah, there we go. Should have pop for more lumberjacks. Yeah, then again, we don't really need them right now. So let's build these here, unless we lose our entire army, because surprisingly that's going to be expensive. There's not as much money as it might look like, but let's go with the slaughterhouse for now. Do those actually, those do gain experience, that's nice. Okay, you just check out the corner here. Let's actually see what's down here. If there's more economic buildings, we may as well go for those. Nice, nice. But I don't think there's anything here. Maybe more elves, but nothing that's truly of interest, I would assume. No, it doesn't look like it. So the Ents. I'm not quite sure whether our melee guys are any use against those. We probably want to make sure that Saruman lights the one on fire that we have. And Tribiat, he'll be level 10. He's going to be tough. And the thing with the Ents is also that they do have a pond here. And while I'm not quite sure how smart they are about putting out the Ents, it still takes them a while to actually die. So let's see how we handle this. What we're going to do for now is we're going to just target these guys here from up here to see. Okay, then let's just retreat. Oh great, there's even more elves. I thought I got rid of you. So we don't want these guys to just fling rocks at you. At us, I mean. Okay, so we're going to retreat here. I'm going to fight these on my terms. And let's wait for these guys here to arrive. Is that... Where is Tribiat, actually? Okay, there's a ton of them now. That's just not so great. Oh, there we go. That's him, I'm pretty sure. Okay, so you blast this guy here. Yeah, Tribiat has a million hit points. So he's going to just walk through these guys here. Kind of, but we needed dozens of guys to kill this guy here. So let's see how many of my guys here survive. Let's just attack with these here. Yeah, but I just need to kill this guy here. Can we even blast? I'm pretty sure he's not going to fall over. But he's almost dead. The rest of the guys aren't that bad, but this guy here... Maybe I should have done some hit and run here, because he's quite nasty. There we go, that's a lot better. Okay, let's see how many guys are actually left. There's actually a decent amount of troops left. It's not as bad as I thought it would be. I'm also not sure how many guys regenerate when you build troops while your troops are weak. So let's just hang out here for a moment. Wait until we stop regenerating, and then we can see about these guys here. I wish I had a general style support power, that'd be awesome. The rest of the guys should be easier to kill. Still not easy, especially if they all come after us, but we might just set some of them on fire and then see how many of them die. Let's just make sure that we have all the upgrades here, really. I mean, there's really only two anyway, so but just to be sure. Okay, looks like our survivability was actually kind of good, and I think it was ultimately beneficial that so many of my guys died, because now they regenerate with full health, as opposed to us having these half-dead troops here. Okay, maybe that wasn't so bad, so we're just going to hang out here for a bit. Regenerate, let's make sure that our workers work. and that the money is flowing in. Yeah, it seems we probably have the maximum amount of guys still. We might have lost like a troop or possibly two, but it doesn't even look like it. Yeah, looks like Tribe failed to completely trample even a single troop. I'm mightily impressed here. Alright, so you take a step back. I'll use Saruman to set guys on fire, but I should have enough quite literal firepower with these guys here. Yeah, it seems I lost one troop. That's totally okay. I'm not too concerned about that. You can come over here. And then I should be where I was before. Yeah, that actually looks pretty good to me. These guys here also kind of just hang around. The question is, will these guys resurrect Treebeard? I hope not. I mean, he's indicated as dead, so I hope he's dead. If you know what I mean. Anyway, what we don't have yet are pikemen, but pikemen aren't really any good against Treants anyway. Which I mean, sorry, did I say Treants? I mean Ents. Yeah, D&D had to change that at one point because they got sued by the Tolkien estate. And yeah, let's just make sure that you have your upgrades here, and then we'll be fine. That's kind of the thing with horsemen or riders in general, and also these Ents here. They're unkillable against a lot of guys, and then they're also incredibly weak against other targets. So the counter system here is rock hard. Also, let's take another step back here. Let's have them come to us. You can... Oh. Yeah, so these guys here go down way, way faster than Treebeard. It's not even a comparison. And they are tough, because this is still single units. Oh. So these guys were cheering, and then... Okay, there we go. Let's do that. If these burn, I'm not quite sure whether anybody gets any experience. But anyway, let's see whether you can set multiple on fire. I don't think we can, but let's give it a go. We certainly can set one on fire. There we go. And that also that does deal a nice amount of damage. Everybody please fire. Thank you. Boom, dead. Okay, let's take another step back. I know we have a lot of cannon fodder troops here, but we don't want to follow them too much. Even though we haven't really leveled up anyone. We have the banner upgrade, but that's not a true level up, is it? Has anyone reached a higher level? It doesn't even look like it, does it? But no matter, let's just regenerate a little bit more. And then we should see. So I'm going to build another one of these troops here, and then let's see whether the other troops regenerate fully or whether that stops the regeneration when my pop fills up. They might also regenerate before this troop is here is ready, but let's see about that. Oh, almost there. Okay. Yeah, we've done that again. That's nice. Yeah, so we're above the limit now. Yeah, so they do regenerate even if you're above the limit. That's good to know. I guess you can cheat the system a little bit like that. And I guess we could also have a couple of guys cannibalize one another to level up. We might do that during one of the other stages, just so we have some ground troops that are slightly less useless. But let's see. For now, there's four of these guys left. I guess you don't even actually have to kill them. You just have to destroy the Entmoot, but... Well, gonna do it now, so let's just set them all ablaze, and then let's retreat a little bit. They do gain a speed bonus when they're on fire, so they have a higher chance of actually reaching... Oh, careful here. And you burned. Literally and figuratively. There we go. Yeah, the boulder here is not going to kill anyone right now. This will do it. There we are. So we should be fine here. Building... Did they rebuild anything here? Whatever. Did we lose another troop? It doesn't really matter. Just kill the pit and... Or the... Not the end pit. End moot and be good with it. Which apparently has a lot of hit points, because this takes quite a while. Even though we do have firebolts. Yeah, I think they trample the troop or two, but that's okay. Can also actually, you know what? Is that okay? We may, yeah, well, whatever. You might want to build different troops doing one of the next levels anyway, so let's just go for it. Saruman, can you set this on fire? Yes, you can. Not that it really does much, but we may as well use your abilities. Warm time. That will be unlocked next time, I assume. This is slightly anticlimactic now that we just hang around here. But it's okay. Going to get there slowly but surely. Mostly slowly. Almost there. Just a little bit more. I guess maybe this is to make sure that you don't just hit and run it.
A new power is rising. Victory is at hand.
Well, that was somewhat terrifying, so let's just play some jolly music. Unit ranks gained a lot, but then again we just bought upgrades, so that was kind of cheating. We conquered the forest. Nice. So let's see. Yeah, nobody even reached level 3. I guess we might have to cannibalize some guys here, but let's see about that. Thanks for watching and see you next time.